up, guys? It is Canadian Guy here, back with episode number 11 of the Buffalo Sabres GM1 franchise series here on the channel. In the last episode, we went through the draft, the re-sign stage, and we are now in free agency, where I have two offers sent out to current free agents. One of them we are already very familiar with, and one of them is more of a depth signing, but we are going after Victor Olofsson, looking to bring him back. I did not plan on trading this guy at the trade deadline going into it, but the offers I was getting were just too enticing for me not to consider, and I obviously made the trade with the Nashville Predators, and now he's back in free agency, and I want to re-sign him. So I have given him a four-year deal worth $24 million, that's $6 million per, and Dennis Cholowski, I've given him a two-year deal worth $2 million with $1 million per. And we are just going to simulate to see if we get those guys. We also have some scouts that are going to be signing some contracts. So hopefully we get all of our scouts. We have a brand new and very decent looking scouting department this year. Just moving along. Kelly Knuble, he is the AHL head coach. Willow Franzen, yeah, we need to offer her another contract. So I'll do that right now. So it was Willow Franzen. I don't remember like what tier of coach she was in, so I'll just sort by all and find her here. She is an NHL assistant coach, but she's going to be an AHL assistant coach. Willow Franzen, give her a three-year deal worth $700K. And hopefully we still have some offers going up to some scouts. We do. All right. Spike Crosby. Not Sydney, but Spike. Adam Pody we get. Lydia DeMello. Agnes, I don't know. Zadina Novik. Miroslav Tatar. Norbert Schroeder. Moving along. Rob Schremp. And we do pick up Victor Olofsson. As you saw in the top part of your screen. And Dennis Cholowski, we have a full roster? I didn't know we had a full roster. Hold on. We have 49 out of 50, but how many goalies? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We should have another skater slot. No one's tendered. We should have five goalies. We should have enough space for Dennis Cholowski. Let me give another contract. I might have to make a trade to free up a roster spot then, because I do want Dennis Cholowski on this team. So he was an 80 overall. Is he still here? Yeah, he is. He's 79 overall now. 2 years, 1 million. There you go. But, I might have to make a trade here to free up a roster spot. I don't know who that should be. Fortune. I don't really want to move any of these guys, but I've had to move one. I don't want to move Cedric Fisk. He was a draft pick of ours. I move Casper Bjorkqvist. That's who I'll move. Team who needs some contracts. So 32 seems to be the lowest amount. 30. Yeah, I'll trade him to Nashville for like a 7th round pick in 2028. That worked out fine. So we should have that spot open for Dennis Cholowski now. Willow Franzen joins the team. Can we get a Dennis Cholowski? And we do. Okay. So, let me take a look at the scouting department. 20 out of 20. These guys are not going to be where they are right now. I do want a good scout in the WHL. But this guy's going to go to the U.S. Central. I guess I can't really send them out right now. Change their location. But, yeah, okay. We'll do that at the start of the year number three. But we bring in Victor Olofsson to fill out our top six. He's going to be the top line right wing. So our first line is looking like Sam Reinhart, Jack Eichel, and Victor Olofsson. Our second line is looking like Jeff Skinner, Dylan Cousins, and Casey Mittelstadt. Our third line is looking like Harku Hämäläinen, Shane Wright, and Jack Quinn. Our fourth line is looking like Zach Sanford with Simka Skirgensons in the middle and Tage Thompson on the right. Defensively, we have Dahlin, Jokiharju, Gustav Bear, Juho Levy, Mahura, Casey Fitzgerald, and Dennis Chulawiski being up on the squad. Carson Coleman's could even make that jump to be in the top six this year from 8th overall pick. All right. I did want to check out a contract extension possibility with Dylan Cousins. He does want to come back, so see how much he wants. He wants over $10 million for 6 years. We definitely do have the space. I just don't know if I want to give out a mighty contract like that to a third-year guy. Don't get me wrong. He's probably worth every penny. But, you know, we'll see how he does this year. And by the trade deadline, we're not trading this guy because he's a pending free agent. He is a RFA, so we got him under control for the next 3 years, or 4 years, I should say. This guy is obviously a part of our long-term future. So we do want to get him signed. And if he does cost me a pretty penny, I won't hesitate, but I don't want to give that out right now. I want to see what we can get him at later. See if his price can and will come down. But there's other possibilities of other contract extensions here with another RFA in Tage Thompson. He's made it very clear that he's not going to be a top six guy for us. His role is going to be in the bottom six part of our group, more likely third liner. But, you know, 27 points in 80 games for a third, fourth liner isn't bad. He's a good physical guy. He's tall. He's fast. You know, he has decent puck skills, decent shooting. If he can just get that defensive awareness up a little bit, he'd be a great third liner. But pending RFA, I do want to bring this guy back. So I'm thinking another three-year contract extension worth about a $2 million per. So he gets a $600K raise over 3 years. Matej Petkar, give him a contract extension, 2 years, $900K. Miska Kukinen, he could still be in our plans for our future. Oskari Laskinen, I should say, another 2 year deal. And goalies, Quick and Mandelosi, we're not going to worry about. But three contract extensions being handed out at this point in time. But let's go ahead and simulate up to year number three. Laskinen signs, Thompson signs, Petkar and Kukkonen all sign their contract extensions. So we're good on that front. Going into year number three, I do have high expectations. I think we're done being a lottery picking team. Especially after Shane Wright, I expect him to be like a franchise altering type of pick there. Our top three centers are all franchise centers. And we have the option of moving Cousins to the wing. In a perfect world, Eichel is our number one center. Wright is our number two center with Cousins on the right wing. Hämäläinen is our second line left wing. Sam Reinhart is our first-line right wing. Olofsson's our first-line right wing. And that's our top six right there. But going into this year, Dylan Cousins is an 88 overall. Continuing to grow. I'd like to see that. 91 overall for Dahlin. 83 overall for Luukkonen. All right, I'm liking what I'm seeing here. I'm really liking what I'm seeing here. Ryan Johnson's up to a 79. We have more depth. That's what I like to see. Lennox is up here now. Jack Quinn's an 84 overall. Awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Okay, I'm going to set up some... what am I going to do? I'm going to set up the preseason lineups. First line's going to be Markku Hämäläinen, Shane Wright, Jack Quinn. None of these guys are going to play in the preseason. Cholowiski can... No, he won't play. Ukko-Pekka Luukkonen is going to play. Ullmark is not. Lennox is going to come up and be the backup. Defenseman, Kuhlmans, Johnson, Samuelsson are going to come up for Delaney, Uhilevi, and Ghost. Over the contract limit. Shoot, that's Kuhlmans. Hold on, I got to make a trade here because I do need Kuhlmans to be up here. I guess I do need that extra spot. So before I do that, I'm going to go make a trade here, another one. Which is weird. 50 out of 50. I thought I had 49. Cedric Fist, we got depth now. We don't need him to be riding the pine. 28 seventh. There you go. Got a contract spot. So let's do that again. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. There you go. Chaika, Kukunin, Lano. I would like them to come up for these guys. Over the... Okay, let me go make some trades here. Just so I can free up some contract spaces. I would like my guys to play. And not have to worry. So some depth guys I can move on from. Laaksonen, Kukunin, Soderblom. Who can I move? Hautanen. I could definitely move it forward. I'll move Marcus Davidson. Carolina. They can probably take both. Another seventh round pick. There you go. So we should have enough contract spaces now. Back to roster moves. These guys down. These guys up. Kukunin can go up there as well. I need to send someone down. Just going to Sanford down. And Eichel. For Goucher, Reynolds, Vierling, and Pachurka, Torgerson, Enroth, and Pasujov come up for Cousins, Middlestat, Barbashev, Shilpi, Gergensen's, him can go down for Matej Petkar. Evan Skella and Boucher. Nevin's gonna go up. And Reynolds gonna go up. Okay. And goalies we got situated. Luukkonen and Lennox. Alright. So we're gonna do the preseason in this episode. Don't have to worry about that. Top line, I like Pachurka with Petkar. I actually want Peter Reynolds up there with Luke, Evan, Gallista, Torgerson with Soderblom and Pastujov, I like. Enroth with Pekar and Boucher. Veerling, Lasker, and Evans are scratched. That's fine for now. Defensively, Ryan Johnson with Carson Kuhlmans. So we got a right-handed shot, left-handed shot. He's a right-handed shot. I'll switch him. I want right-handed shots all on the right side, or left side. And then left shots on the right side. Okay. And we have Lekkonen. Lukanen's going to get the starts. I'm really excited for this team. We've got a really good young team here. Really coming together here. Power play. Quinn with Wright and Hamalainen. Petrarch and Kuhlmans. Second line is as follows. Can I have Torgerson in the middle? 65, 75, 74, 65. That's fine. I'll have it like this. Penalty kill. Kukkonen and Samuelsson with Soderblom, sure. And Torgerson, sure. Peter Reynolds, yeah. Pachurka, let's give that to someone else. I'll give it to Tyler Boucher. Okay. All right. Let's go ahead and hop into preseason here. Oh, no, I need to do the scouts here. Assign them to where I would like them to be. So this guy, Stromberg, he is a USA West guy. Change region. USA West. This guy, Spike Crosby, he is a WHL guy. There you go. Z Bennett, Zachary Bennett. He is a USA Central guy. Put him in the Central. That's fine. This guy, Ronald Greer. He is a QMJHL guy. Do that. And this last guy, I believe he's going to be an OHL guy. No. He's going to be a QMJHL guy. And I got to move one of the Q guys to the OHL. What am I doing? QMJHL. So this guy. No. This guy. No. How did I have it? There's one of these guys who are good in the OHL. I don't need four Q guys. So I guess I'll fire this guy. WHL, USA West, West, Central, East. I need one more Central guy. Oh, this was the, but no. So, West. Can this guy be Central? Yeah, he could be Central. Just make it easier. He can be in the Central. So, West, Central, Central, East. NLA, NLA. No. SHL, SHL. Liga, Liga. No. This guy. Which guy needs to be in Russia? Not him. Schroeder can be in Russia. You can go there. Svensson. He can go to Russia. There you go. Liga. Which guy can go to the Liga? This guy, he can go to the Liga. That's in Nordic, correct? Yep. Then SHL. SHL. Wait. No, we need one more SHL guy. Miroslav Tatar can be in the SHL. you go. And then this guy can be in the Dell. Yes. Put him there. So I believe I need one more OHL guy. So I guess I'll just get this guy for now. All right. Now I actually got to sign these guys to do some assignments. WHL, Connor Bedard is in this class. There's two strengths and weaknesses for these guys. I'll go to December 1st for this first assignment. Ooh, December 2nd. Come on. Really? Who's the last player here? Like, who do I need to take out? Fine, quick. And I'll get play style. I guess I won't. Skills? No. No. There you go. Fine. Then I'll get, for just the top guys, I'll do skills assessment till I get to November 1st. Playing style. No? Okay, fine. I don't know why it had to be so difficult. WHL. Potential. Till I get to November 1st, which I already do here. Playing style. There you go. OHL. I'll do potential comparison for this guy because he's a pretty good scout. There you go. Another OHL guy. Strengths and weaknesses. Till I get to November 1st. There you go. The QMJHL. There you go. Not that many QMJHL guys. QMJHL. There you go. Keep moving along. Skills assessment until November 1st. Again, it's going to be difficult, ain't it? There you go. USA West. Strengths and weaknesses. Playing style. USA Central. Check the weaknesses. Not that many like top tier guys in the US, it looks like, this year. So my assumption is it's going to be stacked next year. That one went to December 1st. I got a little bit sidetracked there. This one's just going to go to November 1st. No, it's going to be difficult. There you go. USA East. All right, I guess they're all in the East. But again, still not that like star-studded as it usually is. Playing style. It could be a little bit of a longer episode, but that's okay. Sure, can we get this for all these guys? Playing style. Nope, you're gonna be difficult. Okay. There you go. Swedish Hockey League. Theo Lindstein, Darrett Nilsson's in this class. This one, I guess I'm going to go to December 1st. There you go. Skills assessment for this guy till November 1st. Please don't be difficult. Thank you. In the Liga. I might not do the preseason this episode because we're already approaching like half hour. So I'll do the preseason in the next episode and do all that other stuff in the next episode as well. So we're just going to keep moving along here. Three more scouts to assign, and then we will wrap it up. So just moving along. I can't see because of the damn song. How does plant cell take that long? I don't get it. Thank you. Looks like a good Russian prospect in this one. November 1st. Then this one I'll do potential comparison. Take me to December 1st. There you go. All right. So we are here at the start of the preseason. I have assigned the scouts. We are ready to go. So let's get in simulated up to the game against the Boston Bruins. 9-game trial warranted. I'm assuming that's for Markku Hämäläinen, in which it is. The plan is for him to play the entire year in the NHL. He's NHL ready. I'm just trying to do whatever I can to make this coach happy. 9-game trial. Fine. I'll give you until the middle of November. I'm your boss. I'll do whatever I want. Okay, AJ? Calm down. I believe that's another OHL scout, so I'll go ahead and do him real quick. Go ahead and assign him. Skills assessment, I guess. November 1st. Please just work out my favor. Yes. All right. So we're good on that front. First game of the preseason is against the Boston Bruins. Make sure the lines are all set up. And they are. Quinn's on 83. I thought he was an 84. Okay. Coleman, 79. All right. We are ready to go. So first game here against the Boston Bruins in Boston at the TD Garden. Excuse me. Let's see how we do. Ukko-Pekka Luukkonen should be in net. Here we go. First period, we're up 1-0. Matej Petkar gets the goal. Just over 3 minutes into the game. Second period, Boston ties it up. It's Jacob forced back a Carlson against Tristan Lennox. So I guess it's Lennox in the net and not Luukkonen. But that's okay. Third period. Moving along, and Ralph Kidney gets a goal. I'm not sure if it's Ralph Kidney. Something Kidney gets a goal in Tristan Lennox, 2 minutes in. Martinuk gets another goal. It's 3-1 Boston. We're just going to simulate, and we actually tied it up. Jack Quinn at 12 minutes, and Ryan Johnson at 143, and we're going to overtime. I was not expecting that at all. In the overtime period, we are going to a shootout where we come out on top. Shane Wright, Jack Quinn get the goals in the shootout for us. And Craig Smith for Boston, but it wasn't enough as we overcome a 3-1 goal deficit to win our first preseason game. Second game here against the Florida Panthers. I want to make sure Ukko-Pekka Luukkonen is in the net for this game. Did Shane Wright get a point? He did. He got his first assist. The preseason. John Juszczyk Paczurka also got a point. Okay. At home at the KeyBank Center in Buffalo, New York, against the Florida Panthers. Let's see what happens. First period, no score. Second period, tied 1-1. Ricard Raquel and Matthias Samuelsson get a goal for their respective teams. As we go to the third period, tied at 1. Rhodes shooting him by one, and Henrik Bergstrom gets a goal to give them the lead. It's 2-1 with just over 12 minutes to go. Power play, we get nothing for it. Aaron Ekblad at the 10-minute mark gives them a two-goal cushion. We're down 3-1. 6 minutes, 5 minutes, 4 minutes, 3 minutes. Sam Gagner makes it 4-1. That's going to do it. We do get a late goal from Carson Coleman's, but it's not enough as we fall 4-2 against the Florida Panthers. As we travel out to Ottawa to take on the Senators. First period, we're down 2-0. Logan Brown and Tyler Cleven get the goal for the Senators. Second period, three goals for us, but we're down 4-3 as Pastrnak gets two goals. Halleruk gets a goal, Jack Quinn gets a goal, and Halleruk gets another goal. We head to the third, down by one. 5 minutes gone. No goals, no nothing happening so far. We're being outshot by 8. 10 minutes gone. Still 4-3. Rudolf Balcers makes it 5-3 with 7:48 to go. With under 5 minutes to play, just looking like it's going to be the insurance record that they needed. And we fall 5-3 to the Ottawa Senators in Ottawa. As we head back home to take on the Montreal Canadiens. Let's make a lineup change so we can get some of those guys that are not playing in there for some games. So two defensemen and two forwards. Leno, I'd like to keep him playing. Chaika, Samuelson, Kukkonen. I'll get Miska Kukkonen out. It's minus 5. Get Laxon in there. And Matej Petkar. Only played about 11 minutes tonight. I'll get him out. Tyler Boucher, about 9 minutes. I want to play him more. Get him up to the second line. Enroth, I'll sit him in favor of Nevins. Okay. Evan Galista is going to be on the fourth line, I guess. That's fine. Get him against Montreal. At home at the Quebec Center. First period, we're up 1-0. Shane Wright gets his first goal. Second period, still 1-0. Heads to the third period with a 1-0 lead, but they tie it up literally 16 seconds in. Jonathan Drouin gives them the lead. Jan Mysak gives them a 2-goal lead. Power play. Long power play, we do nothing with it. Cole Dubinsky gets a goal for the Habs. We're down 4-1, and we lose 4-1. Four third-period goals. That's a collapse if I've ever seen one. And we lose three straight in the preseason to fall to 1-3. The game against Detroit. Still at home. First period, no score. Second period, we're down 2-0. Fabry and Lockhart get a goal for the Red Wings. We're down by 2, headed into the third. Can we get any offense going? About 10 minutes gone. Still nothing. Haven't had a shot in a minute. And Barry Boulay gets an A3 goal lead. And that's going to do it. We lose 3-0 at home against the Detroit Red Wings. Game against Tampa Bay in Tampa Bay. Make another lineup change. So Boucher, he's getting more playing time, but no points at all. So he's going to be benched in favor of Matej Pekar. Defensively, Lexington not bad. Chaika, minus 6. Guess it's not that bad. I'll get Kukkonen back in. Goalies. I need Lennox to play another game here. He'll play against Tampa. So Lennox is in net against the Tampa Bay Lightning. We're also 1-4 in the preseason. First period, we're down 1-0. Anthony Cirelli makes up 1-0 in literally a minute into the game. Second period, we're down 2-0. Tyler Raddysh makes it 2-0. Head to the third, down by 2. We get an outshot pretty bad. Penalty kill. It's a long penalty kill. And we can't kill it off as Braden Point gets a power play goal in the last minute. We're down 3. Been outshot heavily. More than double. 5 minutes left. We're going to be shut out for the second straight game. And we are. Two straight games we've been shut out, so no offense coming from this Buffalo Sabres practice, our preseason squad. I was about to say practice squad. As we are having trouble finding goals. Last game against the Toronto Maple Leafs. First period. We're up 2-1. Elmer Soderblom ends the streak. Mitch Marner ties it up. Then Peter Reynolds gets us the lead. Second period. 3-1. Matthias Samuelsson gets us a two-goal cushion headed into the third. 5 minutes gone. It's still 3-1. We're hanging in there in the shot category. Penalty kill. And Pierre Engvall gets a power play goal to make it a one-goal game with about 5 minutes left. 3-2-1-32, and that is it. We win our final preseason game against the Toronto Maple Leafs by a score of 3-2. Okay. So let's take a look at team leaders and points. See how spread out it was. Jack Quinn got 4 points leading the team. Matthias Samuelsson had 3 points in 7 games. All right. Sasha Pastryshov got 3. Pekar got 3. Wright, Kulemans, and Pechorka got 3. 2 for Johnson, Hamalainen, Evan Gillista, and Torgerson. Some guys who didn't get points, who I wish would have. Boucher, Chaika, Leno. They didn't get any points. Goaltenders. Lennox, he wasn't bad at 96%, but Pekka Luukkonen, she's not performing the way I'd hope. And I don't know why. But hopefully he can turn it around to be our franchise goaltender back there. But this is where I am going to wrap it up. In the next episode, we'll get to start on year number 3. But thank you guys for taking the time to watch this episode. If you enjoyed it, leave a like. If you really liked it and want to see more content on what you just saw, hit the subscribe button. And I'll see you guys in the next episode.